Skies all open wide, geese go high and over. Oh, now you're a beachcomber, fistful of samphire, sea lavender. See ya next year.
Hello and welcome to Deepdale Podcast, September 2021. Fantastic to have you with us. Thanks for listening. We're concentrating on Deepdale Festival in this episode. It's just 2 short weeks away. We've got an amazing lineup of the most fantastically talented artists. Chris has outdone himself this year on putting together the program. And so we figured let's hear from the artists how the last 18 months has been, how their creative process is working, and what they're feeling about being out there and playing live gigs again. So I chat to Tim from the Three Daft Monkeys, Jason from Little Red Kings, two of the Shackleton Trio, Lucy Grubb, Katie Doherty, Chris Fox, Emma O'Reilly, and two of the Brighter Than Trio. Thanks for listening. If you want any more information on the Deepdale Festival, head to deepdalefestival.co.uk. Really hope you enjoy the interviews and the fantastic samples these artists have allowed us to include in this podcast. If you want any more information about Deepdale Festival, please head to deepdalefestival.co.uk. You'll find lots more information about the bands that are playing, program information, and of course, how to come and join us for this amazing weekend of live music at Deepdale. Thanks for listening again. Enjoy the interviews. Talking to Tim from the Three Daft Monkeys, who are headlining on Sunday night at Deepdale Festival. We're really looking forward to seeing you guys. It's going to be absolutely awesome. I love your promotional photos. So, you know, very excited to hear you play. It's going to be great.
Thank you. Yeah, well, we're really looking forward to it. But it's part of our, we've been sort of gigging since June. We spent a lot of time doing sort of live streaming during the lockdown period. And it's just nice to be playing in front of people again. It's just what we do and what we love. So it's a real, real nice thing to be doing. And I'm looking forward to Deepdale immensely.
Have you ever been up to the North Norfolk coast? You've ever played up in our...
Well, we did. We actually played, was it Folkener Field?
Oh, yes.
That's not too far from you guys, is it? Back in June, July, I think. That's a really nice festival. Is it Folk in the Field or is it Chickenstock I'm thinking of? I think it's Folk in the Field, isn't it? In the woods there.
There is a Folk in the Field. So I haven't heard of Chickenstock before, but you never know.
No, sorry. That's just that it was in the state. It was east. When we live in Cornwall, everything's east.
Well, I was down in St. Agnes a couple of weeks ago and saw your name up on the board down at the pub near the beach.
Yeah, we play as a duo sometimes. It's me and my partner are the two people in the band, and then we've got another band members as well: Jamie on bass and Richie on percussion. But sometimes we just go out as a duo just to just to have a little bit of fun and a little bit of bread and butter money. So it's a really nice pub down there, isn't it?
Yeah, it's good. Although the weather wasn't beautifully kind to us, we did have a great time in St. Agnes. It was lovely. And How would you know, for those who love the name but have not really heard you before, what would you describe your music, and what are you going to be performing when you come to Deepdale?
Well, it's sort of if you could think of European folk music crossed with a bit of the Clash with a little bit of Hawkwind thrown in, and we spent a lot of our time sort of street entertaining. So we're quite a visual, entertaining, and upbeat festival, fiddle-driven. Just quite good fun, really.
I think that sounds perfect. Perfect for a Sunday evening in the Brick Barn. It's going to be great.
Exactly. Yeah.
Yeah. No, that's going to be really good. The Brick Barn is a wonderful venue, and it works really, really well for bands who are get the crowd going. It's going
we
to
like
be
it. We like people like to dance to our music. They do like to dance.
Fantastic. So a great way to close the festival.
It's not set dancing. It's free. It's free form sort of dancing. You know, you can throw some moves. You know.
Excellent. And you're closing the festival, so you know it's going to be very exciting to have you play. It's going to be superb, and you're following on from Martin Simpson.
Yes, I love Martin Simpson, great guitarist. We've played with him quite a few times over the years, because we've been actually we were celebrating our 21 years as a band this year. We had a big thing last year of 20 years wild, it was called. It's going to be our big tour and sort of best of album, but obviously things went a little bit awry. So now we're doing 21 years wild.
I think 21 sounds great. Is it?
Yeah, you know,
perfect opportunity.
Got the key to the door, haven't we?
Well, thank you so much, man, for talking to me. We really look forward to seeing you in just what is going to be a couple of short weeks away.
Yeah.
And thank you so much. And you know, for anybody who is coming along to the Deepdale Festival, Tim and his band, the Three Daft Monkeys, are all going to be playing on Sunday evening. I think they're on around sort of 8:30, 9 o'clock on the Brick Barn stage. And it should be absolutely fantastic. So look forward to seeing you then.
Thank you very much.
I'm chatting to Jason from Little Red Kings, who are headlining Deepdale Festival on Friday night, which is going to be fantastic. And they are also, you know, many of you will have seen Little Red Kings at Deepdale in the past. We love hosting them in the Brick Barn. You know, fantastic band, fantastic venue for them to really make people dance, which is just awesome. Yeah, we just thought it would be lovely to have a chat pre-festival, you know, just a couple of weeks away. I don't know how that rolled around quite so quickly. And just see, you know, how you're doing and just check you're looking forward to the festival, really. So how are you doing, Jason?
Well, really good. And you're right. We really are looking forward to the festival. We love playing Deepdale, actually. We've done it a couple of times in the past, and to be headlining it, we're really looking forward to it. And we're gonna stay over and make a bit of a thing of it. So, you know, we can't wait.
It's going to be great. And you know, it's been an interesting 18, 20 months, hasn't it, really? How have you guys, when was the first time you were back on stage? Have you done many gigs in the last few months?
Well, we have, because and sort of pride ourselves on this. We were able to do acoustic gigs and very scaled down. So when we've played Deepdale in the past, you may have seen us in our full electric lineup. But I really enjoy doing the acoustic stuff, and we were able to scale that down to tiny, tiny form. And we rearranged all of the songs to make them work acoustically. And I think we started to play them a lot better as well because of that. And so we were doing these little scaled down acoustics in the corners of pubs with limited seating and all of that kind of thing. Well, really for 18 months. And then as of 2 weeks ago, we did our first electric gigs. So we've now done 4 electric gigs. So that was tough getting back into it. But I really do feel like the songs have benefited from us playing them at such a low volume to very small crowds. My kind of dream, as I've said to the other guys, is we've done these acoustic gigs. We always did acoustic stuff, but my dream is to now form those two bands. So the pre-pandemic Little Red Kings kind of joining with the pandemic Little Red Kings acoustic and putting them together to form this kind of new outfit. It'll be called the same, you know, Little Red Kings, yeah. But it's just the feel and how we play them. That's my dream. I don't know how well that's going to work, but I want to take those two completely polar opposites of the two versions and put them together to form this kind of, it's all about the groove and the lulls and the dynamics and the quiet. That's my dream anyway. So we're working on it. I mean, I'm not saying that we're suddenly going to, in the middle of our set, you know, pull out a cajon and a ukulele and do a little quiet number, but we've worked more on the harmonies because we're doing the acoustic versions, and we've really sort of thought about that more. And then just transferring them over to the electric version, they don't always work as well because it's such a wall of noise. So it's about, scale, using the same instruments, but scaling the music down so that these elements can pop up. You don't all have to play all of the time, you know, and yeah. That's the first thing that all bands do when you're working out a new song. What's my part? Yeah, I mean, it should be, should I even have a part? Because yours is so beautiful. Do I want to even mask it, you know?
Yeah.
So, yeah it's about that.
That's awesome. Thank you so much, Matt. And I hope your podcast is going well. You know, are you enjoying still doing that?
I really enjoyed doing the podcast. I hope we all do. And it's something we did in lockdown, and but we want to continue that. So we're now on episode 42 or 3, and basically it's we choose a subject of chat every week, and the idea from the start was we don't hold back and we do reveal everything, however awkward or embarrassing that might be. We lay it out, and then we have a live act on every single week as well, local band or local artist. So now we're on 42 or 43, that's 42 or 3 songs, you know, that we've recorded for other people and put on there. So I really enjoy the podcast. So yeah, check that out, anyone listening. So get in the van with Little Red Kings. I'll just type in Little Red Kings and the podcast will pop up.
I think it's great. So we can look forward to, a kind of a compilation album of all of those amazing tracks that you've recorded during that time, which would be great because you've had some amazing artists on there, fantastic people.
We have, yeah. So, yeah, Vagabond and EBB, Lucy Grubb. Who else have we had? Love Songs for Losers. We've had the Renadines full band in. Sam Coe's been in. Goes on and on, actually. I mean, yeah, there's been absolutely loads of people come in. All fantastic as well. We don't, we sort of choose people that we think can probably cut it and they've got something interesting to say, so we have a chat, and then we just let them play, you know, and it's... It's good, really good.
Fantastic. Well, we'll make sure to put a link up on with this podcast. And thank you so much for chatting with me. And I'm so looking forward to you guys playing on Friday at Deepdale Festival. That's going to be a fantastic evening. Mammal Not Fish just before you, and a whole lot of other fantastic artists before that. So it's going to be great to have you with you, and it's going to be kind of very strange to be back in the Brick Barn with live music, I have to say, but I'm really looking forward to it as well.
Yeah, me too. I'm really looking forward to it.
I'm chatting with two of the lovely members of, clearly there's three members of the Shackleton Trio. They're home, we're on Zoom, and we're really excited because they're returning to Deepdale for the Deepdale Festival in just 2 short weeks' time, and they're performing on Saturday evening on the Orchard stage. How are you guys? How are you, lovely people?
Hey. Yeah, we're good, thanks, Jason. Yeah, really good. How are you?
Yeah, I think so. I think so. You know, just, you know, it's that sort of to-do list that's growing. But, you know, that's okay. We'll get there. It'll all be here and gone in a flash. So, but we're so looking forward to seeing live music at Deepdale. It's just been too long.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, it's one of our favourite places to play. We're itching to get back there.
Have you managed to get on stage much since, you know, sort of since the roadmap came into being?
Yeah, we managed to, I suppose around May time, we started gigging again, really, didn't we? We've had...
we've had quite a lot of nice kind of outside sort of seated events.
Yeah, we did a nice thing for Folk Expo over in Dis, and that was sort of one of the first gigs back, I think, wasn't it? It was really nice to be invited to do that, and... just a smattering, a couple of festivals and stuff over the summer, which was nice, and they all felt, everything just felt safe and good. It's great to be playing again.
That's cool. And has the last sort of 18 months been productive, you know, musically, or has it been a kind of like, you know, no inspiration, kind of just watch box sets?
It was meant to be productive. So there were great intentions to be very productive.
I kind of started too many projects, and then I keep getting distracted, then moving on to the next thing, and then not finishing the previous thing. So yeah, I've sort of shot my net out wide and not caught any fish.
Well, that does not make me feel good.
We've the three of us have been starting to record our third album, and I think the whole idea was that, you know, doing that at home in our home studio and stuff, we would we'd be doing just sort of doing it leisurely in our own time, but I think we really have been doing it very leisurely, very much in our own time. So it's we're taking our time with it, but it's getting there, and we're really looking forward to unleashing that on the world.
Fantastic. Yeah, it's going to be very exciting. Will we hear any of the new songs at the festival, do you think?
Absolutely.
Yeah, we're certainly playing a few of them in our set at the moment. We won't have it. We won't have that ready for the festival, unfortunately, but... we're getting there.
Fantastic. That's really cool. Well, we're really looking forward to you guys playing. It's going to be fantastic. And, if anybody's hasn't decided what they're doing about coming to the festival, you really want to see these guys. They're in the evening on Saturday in the Orchard Tent. And for anybody who remembers their appearance as the incarnation that is Cobbler Bob in the courtyard at the last festival in 2019, then they definitely need to come along. It's wonderful. And you've done Sunday sessions with us and things like that. So it is really, really exciting to have you back. And it's been far too long since we had live music. So, yeah, really looking forward to seeing you. Thanks for chatting with me, guys. And we'll see you in a couple of weeks' time.
Baby blues, stretched out to stripy wing. Come on with me, past 2 inches every day, from 6 inches up to 6 foot, or buying a month of May. She eats me out of house and home. Turns out she has 3 stomachs. What do I do with my funny bird? I'm really rather flummoxed. Ostrich for sale, ostrich for sale, I bought a bloody ostrich, I should have bought a quail. Ostrich for sale, ostrich for sale, I bought a bloody ostrich, I should have bought a quail. Well, I didn't buy a chicken, I didn't buy a duck, I bought a bloody ostrich, and she doesn't give a hoot.
I'm chatting with the lovely Lucy Grubb, who I'm hoping many of you have heard of, and if you haven't, you should have done. Lucy is playing on Saturday at the Deepdale Festival, and it's going to be fantastic to have you. Lucy, I'm right thinking you've played at Deepdale before. Yeah.
Yeah, we did play a good few years ago. That was
it for the Hooger, I think you played in the past, or did you play at the festival? I can't remember.
I think we actually played at the festival. We were meant to be playing the Hooger last year.
That's right.
I think, yeah.
I knew I think I should have done all my research and happily looked at the plans, but, you know, this is a podcast and a raw podcast. So, you know, what can I say? So how has the last sort of 18 months been? Have you been in a creative black hole or a creative kind of like vibrancy?
So kind of pre-pandemic times, we were kind of in the middle of recording my third EP, and as things moved kind of into lockdown, that kind of settled a bit and we couldn't really do much in terms of going into the studio, but luckily we use my bass player Kev. He has a studio that we record in, so when things started to kind of open up a little bit and we could start seeing people, we'd kind of have one person drop into the studio and record their part. And it kind of rolled like that for the next few months, and we started kind of getting the EP sorted and together, and kind of ready for the mixing and mastering process. So for us, the kind of lockdown period was kind of a blessing because we got to work on the songs in the studio in a way that we probably couldn't have done if we were busy gigging all the time. Mm-hmm. And when kind of restrictions lifted a bit, we could all get into the studio and start working on the set list and kind of expanding songs and working on the new songs. So in a way, it kind of gave us that kind of breathing space to work on our recorded material and also to work on the set list and to make sure that when we come back to live, we actually have something really great that we can kind of bring to the table.
Exciting. Fantastic. Mm-hmm. So certainly not a wasted 18 months then.
That's great. Not at all. I think it was kind of nice to have that breathing space because we'd been playing gigs for so long and kind of building up to the next gig and never really having time to just actually work on things. It was a good period of time and quite a productive period.
And I'm always fascinated. I remember chatting with Katie Spencer, probably must have been back at the 2019 festival. She kindly came on the podcast and we were just talking about her writing style, and same with a couple of other artists, and it just I find it fascinating kind of how you go about it. So one of the artists said, oh, you know, I take about 15 minutes to write a song and then I just sort of pair it round. And Katie said, oh god, no, I spent ages, you know, working on it. How does your creative work, is it the words or the music, or is it kind of a bit of both that comes first?
Well, I wish I could say 15 minutes. That would be the ultimate dream. Sometimes it works like that. Sometimes when you have an idea and you kind of have the creativeness kind of flowing, it does kind of come out in a few hours. But for me, I have to kind of have a baseline of some chords or, that is usually how I sit down and write. It's usually on a guitar and I'll kind of come up with a few chords or like a chord sequence or a chord structure. And then I can kind of build a melody line on the top, and then the lyrics kind of come in afterwards. I do usually have like a bank of lyrics that I can kind of go back to, but it does all depend on the melody line and kind of the bass line that I'm working with, because each time it's a bit different. But most recently I've been trying to shake things up, because I think it's always good to kind of try something different, especially when you're going through kind of writer's block, which I have been for a few months. So I've kind of try to take all the pressure off, not try to sound like me or Americana, and kind of just sit down with a guitar and just write something, because I think that's quite therapeutic, to not have to think about things too much.
That's cool. Excellent. And we're really looking forward to seeing you back at Deepdale. It's going to be absolutely fantastic. And, you know, just having live music again at Deepdale will be awesome. And Chris has done an amazing job with the lineup. You're in very good company on the Saturday. So really looking forward to you playing, you know, and I'm really pleased we're going to be there. How is gigging been, you know, since the roadmap kicked in? Have you been out on the road quite a bit? Have you managed to get some gigs in?
Yeah, it's been strange times, because it's kind of relying on people to sort of put on gigs, even though it might not be financially viable for them, especially when you don't know whether audiences are going to come out and actually support and watch, because you don't know how people are going to be feeling in this time. But luckily for us, over the past few months, we've been able to actually get out. We've been doing quite a lot of local gigs. We played the Empire in Great Yarmouth, which was really lovely. But most recently, last week, we got to go out to Birmingham to play Moseley Folk Festival. And that was just honestly amazing. And it was so nice to get out of kind of Norfolk and to play to a bunch of people that we haven't played to before. So yeah, that was lovely.
Did you hear Chris and Sheila in the background cheering you, because they were at Moseley?
Yeah, I did say, I kind of was like, is anyone from Norfolk here? And got a few cheers in the crowd, which was really lovely. But I mean, it's always nice to play local and you're always going to get a great crowd and a great response. But it was really nice after the last kind of 18 months to go out and play somewhere I'd never played before. And get a really great response too. So that was fun.
Yeah, cool. Excellent. Well, we're really looking forward to seeing you. Can't believe it's just 2 weeks away. It's just, I don't know how that came about. And really lovely to chat to you. Thank you. If you had to choose one of your tracks that you wanted me to play a sample of, what would you choose?
One of the new EP, Waste My Time, would be a good one.
Excellent. Great. Thank you so much for chatting to me, Lucy. That's really kind of you. And we'll see you in a couple of weeks' time.
Yes, really looking forward to it.
I don't have the energy to chase you away. And I don't have the empathy to think of things your way. And I don't have the power to make you feel the same. Possess the knowledge to read between your lines, and I don't like to bargain with the devil in my mind, and I don't appreciate you wasting my time. So don't hold my hand, 'cause I won't look back, and I'm down.
Chatting to the lovely Katie Doherty, who is coming to play at the Deepdale Festival. Very exciting. Katie Doherty and the Navigators is the official title of the act that's playing. It's one of our very special gigs in St Mary's Church, which is a fantastic venue. I'm really looking forward to having Katie playing. So hi Katie, how are you?
Hi Jason, I'm very good, thank you. I've had a bit of a sore throat, so I'm slightly croaky, but I won't be when we come to the festival, thankfully.
That's good news. That's good news. Excellent. So how is the weirdness been for you? You know, have you found a creative kind of black hole or a creative kind of inspiration?
A bit of both. So I live in a very rural location, so on that side of things I'm really lucky in terms of having lots of space and being able to go out for walks and all that kind of thing. But I also have a 5-year-old, so so he kept me very busy during lockdown. And I was lucky enough that I did have work, although, you know, I'm sure with everybody you're speaking to, there's a long list of things that were cancelled. So yeah, we had a full summer tour cancelled, and I work the rest of the time with theatre predominantly. So I was supposed to be taking a musical to Ireland on tour, and that got cancelled as well, obviously. So, but the theatres adapted really quickly. So a lot of my projects moved over to audio. So I still had plenty to do, thankfully. And I did just start working on a new album as well. So
fantastic.
So it's been quite busy.
Have you been gigging since kind of the roadmap came into existence, or is it being still yes. quite quiet?
We've done quite a few gigs. We did Ely Festival, which was just before they sort of, you know, the day of freedom, which is a horrible thing to call it, but
I agree.
we were still in boxes on everyone was in boxes on the field and stuff, but there was still a really lovely sense of just, oh, thank God we can come together and enjoy live music again. And we've done a couple of gigs since then, and we've done a lot of live stream stuff, but I am so excited to be doing a festival that's not going to be in boxes, and sounds like it's going to be in a fantastic venue as well in St. Mary's Church.
I think you're going to work really well in there. It's going to be fantastic. And it's just a really nice, you know, it's an old, it's got a Saxon round tower and a Norman font, and the building is, you know, chalk and flint church, and an amazing wooden roof. And we've had live music in there in the past. So we've done gigs in the church for, I think, the last 2 or 3 festivals. And it's just works really nicely as a venue. So we've had choirs in there and, you know, other groups. And we've had, I'm trying to think who else we've had in there. But it was just, you know, just really lovely, lovely atmosphere in there, and it allows kind of a difference of sense, and also it feels like we're sort of beginning to stretch out into the village, which is quite lovely. It's just the other side of the road, so it's like it's no further than the brick barn is from the orchard, so it's kind of like a sort of a triangle of venues. But I think there's only one other gig happening in St. Mary's Church, so it's sort of something quite unique and special.
Very honoured,
lovely. Yeah, I think it'll be a lovely venue for your music particularly, and it will work really nicely. And just having live music back at Deepdale is just going to be so fantastic. It's just been too long, so it's going to
be great.
We'll
see if we can get the audience singing. It sounds like a space that needs to be full of voices.
Sounds great. Yeah, sounds awesome. Yeah, we'll give people heads up that they need to come with singing voices.
Yeah, warm up.
excellent. So what's between, because it's only 2 short weeks away, have you got any other gigs between now and then, or are you you having a bit of a calm time?
We are playing tomorrow night in Lincoln. There's a little sort of world music small festival called Beyond Folk, so we're playing there. And then actually the week before we come to you, we are spending the week in the studio recording a new album.
Fantastic.
So we'll be well rehearsed, you'll be pleased to know.
That's brilliant. So we're going to hear brand new songs that's awesome. That's really exciting. That's brilliant. So if you could select any of your tracks, what would you like me to put in as a sample after this?
I think you should put the track that we're named after, which is Navigator, because it's a feel good song, and I think everybody's craving that at the moment. So
that sounds great. Yeah, that sounds great. Well, really lovely to chat with you, Katie. Thank you so much. And I'm looking forward to meeting you in person in a couple of weeks' time, but also hearing you play. It'll be fantastic. And thank you so much for chatting to me. I'll let you know when the podcast is live.
Excellent. Thank you, Jason.
Cheers, Katie. Thank you so much.
I tried to give up, you quietly told me that this was no place for an end. I ran in circles, you ran around with me, you showed me a place I could mend.
Anchor me in flow to while I don't know where I'm going. You have been a constant in the absence of my knowing where I am. You're a plan, navigator of my heart. You are the start. I borrowed your belief and I built it up.
I built it up.
I listened to your words. You are enough.
You are enough. You are enough.
I made your voice the loudest in my head. Turn it up and start again. You
turn it up and start again. Turn it up and start.
I'm chatting with Chris Fox. He is coming to the Deepdale Festival as well, and he is playing on Saturday on the Orchard stage. Caveat there, of course, it is a festival, so, you know, things change at the last minute, as they are prone to do with live music events. But, you know, really looking forward to having Chris play. He was supposed to play in 2020, which, of course, the Deepdale Festival didn't happen. And Chris was very kind and rolled over his booking to this year, which was very good of him. Hello, Chris. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you. Yeah.
How has the last 18 months been for you?
Weird. Definitely quite weird. It started out all right. I think in the beginning, I didn't really have any idea how long it was going to go on for. So I just applied myself to the virtual gigs and said, okay, well, maybe it's just a little, you know, 8 week speed bump and we'll be back to normal, you know, by the end of the summer kind of thing. And then, yeah, but then it just sort of carried on and carried on. And to begin with, it was quite a creative time for me. I sort of took the time to write some songs, and I got four or five really great songs out of this sort of 2020 March to Christmas bit. But then by that point, I played about 50 virtual shows and I was starting to lose my mind because I was just sort of playing in the kitchen to nobody, and you know, people were into it, or you know, whatever was happening. So then I sort of took a break for a couple of months and didn't really do much of anything. And then I've just started to kind of get going again. And now the country's sort of opening up, and a handful of promoters went for it, and then it's like a snowball effect. A lot of people are going for it, so I've got gigs coming in like crazy, which is brilliant. I don't even know where I'm going to be able to do them all, but yeah, it's been a strange time for sure.
Yeah. Well, it's I'm glad at least you managed to get something creative out of at least the first couple of lockdowns, if nothing else. And it's good to know that you're back on stage and entertaining people.
Yeah, it's great to be back, and I think most of all, it's just great to see people out enjoying live music in person again. Yeah. That's you can't create that. It has to be done properly. And it's so good to see people coming out to the gigs and coming and having a listen and, you know, braving it. Because it must be scary for people, and you know, it's not easy, is it? So I'm very grateful to see people in the crowds. I have to admit, it's really cool.
That's good. And for those who haven't, you know, because our regular audience haven't seen you before, as we've said, so what can they expect from your session?
Well, I do lots of, I sort of dabble with lots of different styles. I mean, it's all in the kind of sort of roots genre, but I play around with, I sort of have a transatlantic blend of sort of English and Americana. And then I also do some sort of experimental stuff on the Loop Station, which you could say almost has like a bit of a world music feel to it. But I really dabble with lots of different stuff. I'm very much focused on the lyrics, and whatever the music has to be to bring the story to life, I'll use it. I don't mind. So expect a little bit of everything, really.
Fantastic. Sounds great. I'm looking forward to it. Really looking forward to the session. That'd be fantastic. Oh, that's awesome. Well, you know, we're really looking forward to seeing you. I can't believe it's only just over 2 weeks away. And time has flown, and you know, really looking forward to seeing you. And I hope you enjoy your first experience of Deepdale. The crowd are normally really lovely and they're really appreciative of great musicians. So I'm sure you'll enjoy yourself. And and we really, really look forward to seeing you in a couple of weeks' time. Thanks for talking to me.
No worries. I'm looking forward to I'm really looking forward to it. It's going to be my it's going to be a real highlight this year because festivals just I didn't get to do many in the last year, so it's going to be really special.
Fantastic. That's brilliant.
Come smugglers, come thieves, come men at large, I offer you great sanctuary with a life led by the stars. Come villains and come fiends, and come those in toil, a better life awaits you, and with me you share the spoils. Now we sing hooch, grey and up she rises, let up the sail. Come draw the anchor from the ocean, let good times prevail. It's hooray and up she rises. Boys come to see you share the bounty and the riches. If you join with me, we sing hooray. Life of leisure awaits you. Sign up, you'll see. Come sail the compass point, my lad, and you love more than you need. Well, there's those who live life honestly, but you think you want more. Come see the proof of piracy by the bullion in my store. We sing hooch, grey, and up she rises. Let out the sail. Come draw the anchor from the ocean.
I'm chatting to Emma O'Reilly, one of the wonderful artists that's coming to play the Deepdale Festival. Emma has, you may have seen her at Deepdale before. She's done her a very own Sunday session and she's been involved with other events. And it's lovely to see you. I haven't seen you in so long.
It's great. The last time we were talking was pre-pandemic, sat in the couch at that little common room. At the camp.
And there were the days where you could hold a microphone and hold it to someone's mouth and they could speak and then kind of bring it back, you know, rather than these long booms and, you know, and and Zoom, basically. So
exactly.
Yeah, I have to say, if it hadn't been for Zoom, doing a podcast would have been quite interesting.
I would think so.
Yes. So so how has the last sort of 18, 20 months been for you? Have you been massively creative or kind of a bit of a black hole?
Well, do you know, it's been a really mixed bag. I have been teaching in a college for the last 2 years. So a huge amount of my energy has been into being there for my students and supporting them as much as possible. And that has been, I found that to be a really worthwhile endeavor. You know, I think the lockdowns have been hard on all of us, but they hit young people really, really hard. So it was great to know that I was able to contribute something to those young people while we were in such a difficult situation. And, you know, we might not be out of the woods of it yet, but I think that I'm glad that I was able to do my part.
Yeah.
In terms of my own work, it took a little bit of a beating because of that, you know, kind of the working in such challenging circumstances. But I have managed to do some fairly creative stuff. A lot of it online, as you can imagine. So I did a lot of live streaming during the first pandemic and then the first lockdown. Jesus. Don't be wishing extra pandemics.
Please don't do that. That'd be bad.
During the first lockdown, I did a lot of live streaming on like Facebook. And then in September, as we were about to head into kind of like the second lockdown, I joined Twitch So I've been streaming there 3 times a week, and that's been really fun and really, really good. And it's also brought a lot of people to my music. It's helped a lot of people to find me on Patreon and stuff. So coming out of that now, I'm at a stage where I'm working towards some recordings, some new material to release, and working towards gigging again, getting a band together and actually getting out there to festivals, to venues, and seeing people in real life. So yeah.
It is going to be great to have live music back at Deepdale, and it'll be fantastic to see you there. You know, it's been just been way too long. And yeah. have you managed to do some gigs, but sort of while the roadmap has been ongoing?
Yeah. So people kind of started tentatively booking things with me in around maybe February, March. And I deliberately said no to anything that wasn't like end of August. I just wanted, you know, I wanted to know that as many people were vaccinated as possible, as many people, you know, we had a chance to see what things were going to do, so that I was in a better position of assessing if it was safe to be bringing a band out to gigs and that kind of thing. I feel like the jury's still out on that one a little bit. No, well, like, you know, yeah. It is.
I know exactly how you're feeling about that one. Yeah.
Yeah. I know some people would disagree, and that's okay. For me, I still, you know, you'll see me around Deepdale in my little mask. Just, you know, God, I wouldn't want to pass on anything to anybody, and I'll be doing my little tests before I go there. So that's kind of how I get myself kind of centered for a gig now, which is different to what I thought it would be. I didn't think I would be ever centering with little strip tests, but sure, there you go. I'm looking forward to gigging a bit more. I've had a few gigs now in August. I've done Maui Wowie. I've done Head Out Not Home. And I have some stuff potentially abroad coming up in October. So it's been really great to have a reason to get the band together and to do some rehearsing and getting back into the rehearsal room and doing that kind of thing. It's been really great. And it just feels like being back in my element, you know? So that's been wonderful.
That's good. That's good. Well, we are really, really looking forward to you playing on Saturday on the Orchard stage. It's a lovely open air stage, so you know that should suit you down to the ground, and your style of music will fit that space beautifully. Wonderful. And we're really, really looking for, can't believe it's 2 weeks away. That happened.
Incredible, it rolled around really. So quick.
Very scary. And you know, if I give people a, you know, taster of your music, which track would you choose to kind of to get them to know you?
I would say give them a little taste of Shake.
Shake. Okay.
Yeah.
That's cool. Well, coming up after this will be a little taster of Shake. There you go. So yeah, that's fantastic. Well, really lovely to speak to you. And I hope we get to see you physically in the next couple of weeks. And we look forward to hearing your glorious music again. So thanks for chatting to me, Emma.
Cool. Thank you.
Just cannot compare to you. So beautiful. I just can't do the things you do. So wonderful. And I was shaking, 'cause the sky's gonna fall, when I come to my senses and realize that everything I'm doing is a waste. The breath in my lungs, the songs I have sung, the voice I have been given just to speak my own truth. I need
I'm chatting to the lovely members of, well, two of the lovely members of Brighter Than, occasionally there's three. They're playing at the Deepdale Festival on Saturday on the Orchard Stage.
I've been playing music for an awfully long time. My name's Matt. I'm Matt White. This is Helen White. So we are a family band. We sometimes have Gino, our little lad, playing the drum or the violin or the cello with us. And we've found a nice little niche down here in Northamptonshire where we live, and we play out quite a lot, don't we?
We've landed well in musical country, and we make our regular pilgrimage over to Norfolk and to Deepdale, where we entertain people there as well, and absolutely love it. So looking forward to doing it again. I'll never forget, Jason, the time that we first went, like when we just rather cheekily sort of made this suggestion and did our first performance, going to the loo on the campsite and seeing a picture of myself on the inside of the back of the toilet.
You know you've arrived then.
Wow, look. Yeah. That's, there you go. Fame. Yeah. But we're really looking forward to seeing it. And the Orchard Stage will work really well for you guys.
It's lovely. It's lovely. Yeah, I like playing a nice early spot as well, because you can play it and then you can just enjoy everybody else.
We're just going
to the whole day waiting.
Watch everyone else.
Yeah, you go. Right, we're on. You can set a benchmark and let them follow.
Very yeah. sensible. Very, very sensible.
And we've...
Thank you so much for listening to the Deepdale podcast. It is really lovely to have you with us, and it's fantastic that you find this podcast useful and helpful. We love putting it together. The whole Deepdale team are involved in various different ways. We'd love your suggestions. Please do let us know what might be able to include, who you'd like to hear being interviewed, any features you'd like us to talk about, any areas of the coast you'd like us to talk about. Do send us an email at podcast@deepdalefarm.co.uk. Love to hear from you, and please do subscribe to this podcast on any podcast directory, website or app. And if you like what you're listening to, please do leave us a review. We'd love to know what people think of the podcast. We would even love it even more if you were happy to tell your friends.
Skies all open wide, geese go high and over. Oh, now you're a beachcomber, fistful of samphire, sea lavender. Sea.